When we go to school, we are taught how to physics and chemistry and poetry and grammar and so many things. Then we go to college. They teach us engineering and medicine and more advanced. But unfortunately, neither in school nor in college nor at home does anyone teach us how to think. Is it true or not? Do you have a subject in school? How to think. Thinking. Subject name is what? Do you have to pass in that subject? Any marks? Any subject? Nothing. And I tell you, if that was a subject, probably we'd all fail. Do you agree with me? We'd all fail. So, no one teaches us, neither at home nor in school. People just don't teach us how to think. You learned how to walk. You learned how to talk. You learned how to write. You learned how to read. You learned all that. Someone taught you all that. Most of it you didn't learn on your own. Is it true or not? You learned. You practiced. It didn't happen just like that. See, you know, all of us have had this most fantastic gift given to us on our birthday, the day we were born. Does anyone buy their own gifts? Your birthday gift, do you buy it? And then happy birthday to you. No one does that. There are some people, you know, who say, you know, who buy a gift and give it to the husband and say, please give it to me. That is possible. Because see, he doesn't know how to choose. Oh, he'll make a mess. Might as well get not disappointed. So I will buy and I'll say, this is your present to me. Okay, happy birthday, give me. That is possible. That is best way to avoid disappointments, actually. Because you'll get something you don't want, so might as well get something you want and say, "Ah, mane aapi deje tu." So you never buy your own birthday gift, and the person who loves you always gives it to you. Yeah? And when a person loves you and gives it to you, and you use it well, the person is so happy, gives it to you again and again, isn't it? But if you don't use it well, or you insult, or you ignore it, then the person feels really bad and says, "Why should I give him something? Next time I'm not going to give him a birthday present at all." Similarly, on the day you and I were born, we all got a buddhi as a birthday gift, right? Every one of you, did anyone have to go and buy it from the market? All of us got it on our birthday as a gift. This beautiful body and what? A beautiful mind. All of us got it free as a gift by God. Isn't it? Now, what are we supposed to do? Okay, just because I have a violin, do I become a violinist? Yes? Just because someone gives me a birthday gift of a violin, I have a violin, does that make me a violinist? Just because I have a sitar, do I become a sitarist? No. First, I have to learn how to play it. And it happens, sometimes when people play it, the neighbors, what? Give money to stop you from playing it. One child got a present, you know, a violin or some, you know, drum or something like that. He says, "I love this present." He got it from his grandfather. He told the grandfather, "Thank you very much. I love this present." He says, "Every day, mom gives me 5 rupees. Don't play in the daytime. And dad gives me 5 rupees. Don't play in the nighttime. I earn 10 rupees out of this gift." You understand? So first we have to do is we have to learn the instrument that we have. We have to learn how to use it. Just by learning Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa, I still don't become a sitarist. Isn't it true? I can't go and give a public performance. Just because I know Sa Re Ga Ma, I can't become a public performer. I have to practice. I have to practice. Not only practice, first I have to learn in depth. How to play it? It can't one rag I know and that's all I keep playing. Everyone will get bored, isn't it true? And that's what happens. There was one lady, you know, she used to cook fantastic food. I used to love her cooking, my friend's mother. But when I went to her house, she's saying, "My God, we are sick of her food." I said, why? He's saying, anything new she learns, she tries it out 25 times at home. And you all get the best of it, and we get all those practice sessions that she goes through. You understand? So what happens is, you have to practice till you become perfect, and then you can give a performance. Is it okay? Now similarly, we've got this buddhi. We've got this beautiful mind. So first and foremost, what should we do? We have to learn how to use it. I don't know whether you're aware, supposing for singing or for playing any instrument, or even in life anything, if you learn it the wrong way, it's very difficult to unlearn what you've done wrongly. Do you agree with me? Vedic chanting, I tell you, we have this problem. Sometimes people do the wrong chanting, and then to get them to say it right is so difficult. Isn't it? It's very difficult because you've learned the wrong thing, then to get it. Even ordinary habits, to unlearn an habit, you know, to take it out is very difficult. It's tedious. Now imagine an outer habit, which is so difficult to take out. If you've learned the wrong thinking habits, how much more difficult it is. Have you understood that? First, you have to learn how to use it. Then you have to go in depth about the whole thing, understand it properly, then perfect it, and what happens? We give a performance without what? In fact, we are performing 24 hours without practice. Yes or no? Bolo. And that is why all our performances are what? Trial and error, hit and miss. Do you agree with me? This is what happens. Lag gaya to lag gaya, nahi laga to. Isn't it? Because we really don't know. We've not practiced it. We don't understand it. We don't understand our instrument well enough. Isn't it true? We're confused so many times. Namrata Ben sings so beautifully. I've known her 15, 20 years back. And at that time also she used to sing. And now she's, you know, there's a lot of practice. I can see that. And she's doing it so beautiful. What a beautiful rendering she gave, isn't it? I think she deserves one extra clap for that. It's very beautiful. I'm so happy. I have known her a long, long time back. And I think she started her first practice sessions in our ashram. Literally that way. Fine. So, there's a lot of practice. And you can at once, you know, understand a trained voice. Isn't it from an untrained voice? Can you or can you not? Yes. Immediately. Pello swar vagade na khabar pade kya? Isn't it? They catch that swar and you say, ah, pakda usne. Hai na? For those who know. Huh? So you have to be able to. And then that all comes from a what? A lot of practice. Then and then alone you're